Jackrabbit Volleyball returned to Frost Arena on Friday, hosting the Jackrabbit Invitational. The Jacks didn't have any home volleyball on the schedule until October a year ago, but this year's slate starts off with two tournaments hosting some quality competition.
Yeah, you know, we talked about kind of last week about this tournament being very even, and we kind of knew that it would be. Three teams that coming in and plus us that could beat kind of each other on any given night. And I thought we played well against a couple teams, and then we had a couple lapses, and the lapses definitely outweighed the good positive moments that we had this weekend.
SDSU took on Stephen F. Austin in their first match on Friday. The Jacks rallied to push it to five sets, but came up just short.
Yeah, you know, the fight was great. It's a fight that we didn't have last year, and then fight that we didn't that we've seen before. We would let those matches slip. Fought back in that fourth set, got it to five, and then it was 8-7 at the switch, and just had a couple late point runs for them, kind of a 2-point run here, 2-point run there. Next thing you know, they're up three, and we're running out of time.
McDaniel's team returned to the court Friday night against former Summit League member Kansas City. The Jacks and Ruse fought back and forth in the first set, but UMKC prevailed 35-33 and never looked back.
Yeah, it was one of those things where, you know, that had to be one of the greatest sets that any of our girls ever played in. Just the energy, the crowd was up, the crowd was down. It was a great environment. We had a good crowd here that night, and just we lost that first set, kind of took a lot of the wind out of our sails, and we just couldn't seem to recover. And it's things that these girls have to work through. Teams are going to come in and play us hard, especially when we're going to come on our home court. They want to come in and beat us, and so we've got to step up and match that intensity.
Saturday afternoon's final match put SDSU up against Valparaiso, which McDaniel knew would be tough, seeing the Crusaders go 2-0 on Friday.
Valpo's tough, you know, they're kind of hitting on all cylinders right now. They're serving the ball tough, they're playing good defense. For us, we didn't put enough pressure on them to keep them out of system, and that's what we've got to do. We've got to find a way to create that pressure.
So after seeing the Jacks go 3-1 last weekend, the Jacks dropped three this weekend, leaving a mixed bag of results.
I'll start with what I don't like first, just because obviously going 0-3, that kind of jumps to your mind first. But don't really care for the way that we're finishing and the way that we're playing through sets. You know, we have big peaks and big valleys, and we're staying in the valleys way too long. So we've got to find a way to bounce out of those, and we just got to get more offensive. You know, we've got the arms and we've got the ability to do it. And we have to stop making errors. We made way too many errors today, especially. I think 25 errors in three sets, and that's uncharacteristic of this group. And so we've got to fix that first. What do I like? You know, I like this still early in the season, but we still have work that we can accomplish. The young setters are getting better. We have moments where we kind of lose our head just a little bit, but for the most part, we're doing some really good things and making really good decisions. And we're really strong in the middle. So if we can keep getting the ball to our middles, you know, it opens things up for everybody else, and we've got to continue to do that.
So now SDSU will regroup and return to Frost Arena this weekend, hosting four teams in the SDSU Challenge. The Jacks will kick this tournament off on Thursday versus North Dakota.
But UND, and they are actually part of that tournament. We're just playing them on Thursday, so they'll play everybody else for the rest of the weekend, and so we're just able to kind of pull a match out ahead of the beginning of the tournament. So they'll be here. They had a good weekend this weekend as well, so they're going to be strong. And again, kind of a little mini rival we have going with them, so they'll come in ready to go. And then three more teams on Friday, one on Friday and two on Saturday. So. And we finish up with Iowa on Saturday. So we've got to make some changes. We've got to do a few things to ramp ourselves up so that we're playing good volleyball when they get here.